You know, I'll just say a few things, and then certainly I welcome your questions. The first thing I'll note is that Kansas City and the state of Missouri will continue to work hard and continue negotiations with the Kansas City Chiefs and the Kansas City Royals. Nothing passing today changes that reality, that we will continue our ongoing discussions, which truly never ended, with the teams. And we continue to believe that the city and the state that have welcomed, supported, and funded these teams since the 1960s will continue to put a strong foot forward in retention of the teams long term, and I still expect us to be able to retain the teams. I will note that it is regrettable that we saw with the vote today in the Kansas legislature a restart of the border war truce. As I understand the economic incentive border war, you know, we don't have some exception where anything cool that wasn't explicitly written is exempted from it. I think that is regrettable. I think it's short-sighted, and I think the reinitiation of the border war between Kansas and Missouri long-term will be bad for taxpayers in the Kansas City metro. And if you want any such example, look at this very discussion where people are asking, will Missouri copy the exact same tax incentive tools and others? One other thing that I think I will note in connection with it is that, you know, what we see today is, in my opinion, really just a sign that we're still in the first quarter of the stadium discussion. The legislation that is being passed in Kansas, being debated, is legislation that allows for a speculative bond offering. No one knows the certainty of that bond offering at all. And of course, there are many other details that aren't identified. Not identified is the private investment. Not identified is the location. Not identified is really the impact on any communities that are represented. And I think whether you're in Missouri or Kansas, those answers are going to be important long-term for what it is that everyone's trying to do. So on the core, I think it is the sort of situation that is a reality that a lot of people realize could happen. I was somebody who was a supporter of the stadium tax vote in Jackson County, Missouri, back in April. I do think that it is in some ways unfortunate that we're here now. I would have liked to see life be a lot easier with it. That being said, you know, we see something different today. Kansas is looking at a tool that does not look to a jurisdiction-wide sales tax increase. I think that is something that is creative. I would expect Missouri policymakers, both in the Missouri General Assembly and at City Hall in Kansas City, to look at those sorts of tools. But I do think that this is an important time for negotiation, not just saying that a move could never happen. Certainly, I think my friends in Kansas are serious. I have great respect for everyone in Kansas. Governor Kelly, who's Commerce Secretary, will be working with this. I do disagree strongly, and I find really unfortunate. However, some of the comments in the legislature, Missouri loses sports teams, some of the classic border war battles. I do believe long-term that we're one place, and we're one place that's better when we're working together. Perhaps there's a way we get to it in this situation, but regardless, we won't give up on the Kansas City Chiefs, the Kansas City Royals continuing to play in Kansas City.
What do you make of the idea that Jackson County voters had a chance to say yes, they said no, and you know, now this is Kansas taking their shot? We noticed that a lot of that rhetoric didn't pop up until after the bill vote.
You know, I don't agree with that. I think that first, if I were to say that there has not been an opportunity for the Missouri legislature to opine, there hasn't been an opportunity for the Kansas City Council to opine. I am not one who talks about confidential negotiations, but the city of Kansas City, myself, I have been in meetings where we've looked to put forward at least an offer of $400 million plus for one of our professional franchises to stay within the city. Working with our state partners, we look to ways that we can try to build up even more of, I think, an attractive package in connection with that. And so, and by the way, those are tools that are very similar to what's being talked about in Kansas now. I know there's some mystery right now with it, but largely what you are seeing is state sales tax redirections, which are basically TIFs, which exist in Missouri right now. It's just a TIF by another name of state sales tax and a few other tools that go with it. We have those types of tools. And something that excites me about Kansas City, Missouri, and the options that it can put forward is that we have a lot of tools. We have a lot of resources getting things done. Being the largest city in Missouri and Kansas, we have that opportunity, I think, to engage in that discussion further. We will. We also recognize that the state of Missouri is going to be an important part of it, and I'll continue to talk to Missouri leaders with it. So I don't think in any way that Jackson County and that vote spoke necessarily for the entire state of Missouri, the entire city of Kansas City that sits in four counties, or frankly all of western Missouri. That being said, I think what I heard from Jackson County voters, and I respect voters in every situation, they said a few things. We want more details. We want more clarity. We want to look at other ways to fund a stadium obligation. I think you are seeing that discussion now. Our friends in Kansas have helped expand ideas in connection with that. I expect those discussions to expand in Missouri over the months ahead. And so I think that you will continue to see active economic development conversations, which is really what this is all about. How do we make sure that this economic development asset remains, first of all, here in the Kansas City region, and I appreciate that, but I would hope also in Kansas City, Missouri, long term, where we have workers, where we have infrastructure, where we have a lot of things built up for us to support stadiums. What I heard in the Kansas legislative debate today are interesting facets, right? The Chiefs want a 20,000 car parking spot. That is a mighty investment of public land or private land. I think right now where you have some of those things figured out, where you are looking at very necessary and essential long-term highway infrastructure, those are the sorts of things that I think do make a difference. And the Royals have consistently talked about being downtown. And with great respect to downtown Parkville, Lee Summit, Overland Park, so many other places, there is one big downtown in the Kansas City region. That's downtown Kansas City, Missouri. And I expect having that nexus, having that walkability is the very type of thing that we'll see long term.
The relationship between the county executive and the Royals being what it is, where does the city stand on potentially doing an end run around the county, being able to pull this off yourself? I know you've hinted at that in the past. Where does that stand?
I think the city's fully committed to using whatever process necessary to keep the teams here and to put our best foot forward on a competitive economic deal that's still responsible for our taxpayers, but that keeps the Royals and the Chiefs in Kansas City, Missouri. I don't see it as an end around. I think that the county executive and others have had the opportunity to speak about any number of opportunities. I don't know if there's even been a meeting between some parties since the April election. I can say that that's very different in terms of what myself personally have done and Kansas City, Missouri broadly. And so we're going to do all we can to make sure that there can be a successful set of opportunities for the Chiefs and Royals. We heard loud and clear from Clark Hunt last week and Mark Donovan that they said they wanted options. I've had the chance to meet with both teams, and I think they say they wanted to explore options. And that was what the reality was after the April vote. What that means is that there is no person, no individual who can necessarily stand in the way in connection with evaluation of what those options may be.
We talked about kind of the border war and how disappointing it is that that's coming back. Do you have any communication with either Governor Kelly or anybody in the Kansas legislature?
And you heard her say today that she, in her opinion, the Chiefs were not included.
Yeah, I mean, look, here's what I would say about the border war, and there's just probably going to be a difference of opinion in connection with it. First of all, I have great respect for Governor Kelly. I think she's been exceptional for the people of Kansas and, frankly, for the people of our entire region. Here we have a disagreement. What you don't do is say that you have exceptions that in some ways were never articulated. This was an agreement about economic development. And what I heard for hours in the Kansas legislature today was conversation about economic development. It wasn't a conversation just about watching a football game or a baseball game and saying how it has nothing to do with money. The border war truce was about not poaching businesses from one state or the other. Two of the strongest businesses in the state of Missouri are the Kansas City Chiefs and the Kansas City Royals. So if it's about business long term, but if it's about economic development, which is exactly what everyone in Kansas has said, then it falls square within the border war truce. And I think what we saw today was, again, regrettably, my peers in the Kansas legislature abandoning the border war truce, which I think will create more challenges. And here's the issue. If one gets a chance to say, well, that wasn't in the truce, then how many things can we say weren't? Right? Is the next big industrial business, is the next big factory, is the next big anything under the sun something that's not contemplated in the truce? Because what we see now is it's not a story of economic development. You know, I think there is probably, of all the different leaders who have spoken, and I'm somebody who doesn't live far from the state line at all, I'm someone who has concerns with the abandonment of the border war truce more than anyone. And so while I think we'll all try to continue to work strongly across lines, what I can't say is that you will see the same recognition of that border war truce going long term.
I think, have you spoken with her? And then I think if you believe that it's been broken, or do you model what happens next after states that have also sort of had anything like this?
You know, I have not had the chance yet to talk to Governor Kelly personally on this issue. I think there has been staff communication. And again, I respect what she's had to say, which was that this was something that she wasn't necessarily investing the greatest deal of time in, but this is something that she was letting the legislature figure out. So I imagine she still has a decision to make as to whether to veto or not, although she's indicated she will not. I always want to look to ways that we can work together. That being said, I think there would have been strong ways to work together in connection with this issue. We are always welcome to having more conversations on how we can grow the pie for the region rather than pulling things back and forth. What you are seeing today is a discussion about pulling things back and forth, and probably the clearest example and the most disappointing example of that is the fact that this legislation only applies to teams in an adjacent state. So this isn't a story about how can we get an NBA team that goes to the Legends. It isn't about how can we get an NHL team that plays in Johnson County. It's about how we can get the Kansas City Chiefs and the Kansas City Royals from a city that borders the state of Kansas. And so to me, it's fairly clearly about how you poach, how you can poach an economic development activity. And I think that flies in the face of the border war truce that existed on economic development. And I said long ago, actually when there was a discussion as to Clay County, and people were trying to say Clay County versus Jackson County, an economic incentive and tax break race to the bottom is not something that is helpful for this region long term. And I think that's something that we may see here. I commend anyone working to keep the teams here. I think there is a way, and probably there still is a way, for parties on both sides of the line in every county possible to try to work together in connection with it. We had a proposal like that almost 20 years ago with Bi-State 2. We welcome more conversations like that, but I think in the meantime, there continues to be this open competition. We understood it. Everybody's a big kid in connection with the competitions at issue, and now we'll just see what the best tools are to keep the teams here, hopefully, first in Kansas City, Missouri, but certainly in the Kansas City Metro.
Since it's so targeted, how do you come back? Oh, I'm sorry. Since it's so targeted, how do you come back from this? You know, no matter what happens next, if you split them, if they stay where they are, how do you repair this?
The relationship between the states or the teams or what?
Between all the elected officials involved.
You know, I thought Jasmine's telling me something breaking.
Okay. They just passed out.
Okay, yeah. We were anticipating. Okay.
Pass the Senate?
Yeah. Okay. So, you know, in terms of relationships long term, I think there are going to be a few things. First, Kansas City, Missouri has proudly invested in, I think, regional economic development time and again. This week I'm hosting a conference of mayors that's going to have 200 plus mayors, more than 1,000 people. And the joy of that is to bring people to Missouri and Kansas. We're working on a World Cup right now, where Kansas City, Missouri, by the way, is committed to investing $15 million. The next closest local government jurisdiction is Johnson County, I think at about $3 million of investment. You know, I think where we need to talk is, what are we trying to build together? How do we actually make sure long-term that we are working together to grow the pie? And how do we make sure that we're not looking at what is a detrimental battle between each other long-term? Kansas City, Missouri, time and again, has said we want to be on the side of agreement on working together. And frankly, I think the border war truce itself was an example of that. In the 90s and the 2000s, for years, when businesses were jumping from Kansas City, Missouri to Johnson County and to other places, right? Everybody said, all right, we continue to have the battle. Frankly, as soon as downtown got cool and people started coming back into KCMO, we said we are good with taking down the weapons and having some sort of truce. I think it's unfortunate now when we've taken those steps again and again, we continue to see this type of battle. And so I think it takes work. I always welcome outreach from anyone. I think generally we're nice. Somebody's always on the state line, jumping both states. But I think that we need to make sure that there's something where we are working together to build the pie long term, not just taking things back and forth. And I think I welcome a call from anyone in Kansas in connection with signs that we can do so long term, particularly on an issue like this, where there was never a time where Governor Mike Parson, where Mayor Clint Lucas, where any of us said, we're not interested in retention of the teams. It'd be one thing if there was a Jackson County vote, nobody ever said another word. I think it has been clear that Kansas City and the state of Missouri are interested in team retention, and I think it's clear that economic development tools used to poach them away from the state, tools targeted only at the Kansas City Chiefs and Royals, are clearly that violation of the border war truce and the sort of thing that I thought we had gotten beyond years ago. Yes, ma'am.
As the response to poaching attempt is ongoing, who's leading the charge? Who's in the driver's seat? Will it be more of a city, county, or state level?
You know, I think step one, our hope is that everybody works together. We continue to have, I think, strong conversations. I personally have a chance to talk to leaders in our state legislature. We look forward to having more. I think Governor Parson and his office will be an important part of this conversation, and we'll keep the discussion ongoing with them. I think, however, the most important part is that we do probably come together for what is a better and a stronger deal long term. I think that what the mistake was before was that there was a view by some that this could be a Jackson County alone effort. This could be a one jurisdiction type effort. What you have seen is that doesn't work, particularly when you're looking at state level incentives. The state of Kansas has about 3 million people. The state of Missouri has about 6 million. The city of Kansas City has 508,000. Jackson County has 720,000, give or take. I think any of the smaller jurisdictions need necessarily to work with their state colleagues in connection to doing it. But what I will say is this, to the extent that there is an entity that is not interested in that long-term collaboration on any side, we will continue to do hard work to make sure we can get a deal done. This is something that's more important than personalities. It's more important than one individual beef. It's more important than perhaps one viewpoint. This is something that's about how do we keep our teams long-term, how do we keep the brand, the activity, the economic development, and how do we make sure that we support, frankly, the investment that's been made by taxpayers in this situation in the states of Missouri, the state of Missouri, in the county of Jackson, and the city of Kansas City for years.
Certainly. And kind of building off that, where does your confidence come from that Missouri lawmakers can align on a response to this?
What's that, I'm sorry?
Where does your confidence come from that Missouri lawmakers can align together on a response to this?
That's a fair question about what's the next step out of the Missouri legislature. My view is this, that I think the reality has come for everyone. I think the understanding now is that there is a possibility of losing teams. Back during the campaign, I think a lot of people said there is no chance that the teams would look somewhere else. There's no chance they would leave. There's no chance of a vacancy long term. I think that that has been blown out of the water. And I think that leads to some greater reality by the legislature and a greater understanding from them. I'll also say this. I think the legislature, particularly after you get through the primary elections in August, I think comes with a more reasonable view of how you get something done. Instead of political theater, which I think has characterized the Missouri legislature a lot lately, I expect people to care about the future of this region. And I'll say this, you know, this isn't so much just a Kansas City, Missouri issue. I'll be honest with you. You know, if there is a stadium in Wyandotte County, if there's a stadium in Johnson County, or a stadium in Central Jackson County, fancy hotel rooms in downtown Kansas City are going to be full. People are going to go to the plaza. People will be downtown at the River Market. To me, this isn't just really a Kansas City, Missouri issue. The Power and Light District will likely be full before big events and big games. I'm worried about right now Raytown, Independence, East Kansas City, all of Jackson County, frankly, east of 435, and many other parts of our region. And I think, sure, if you're a legislator who maybe doesn't like what Quentin Lucas does every week or doesn't like Kansas City, Missouri, I encourage you to think about Lee's Summit, to Eastern Jackson County, so many Missourians that have invested for a number of years. Because the other challenge is this. If you don't have those teams, nobody has given an idea of what happens with the donut hole that is the Truman Sports Complex. If you don't have the Chiefs at an Arrowhead Stadium, if the Royals have left Kauffman Stadium, what happens there? And not only is there a question of what happens in that space, but you have a gap before you get to development and independence. You have a gap before you're getting to Blue Springs. That starts to become something, I think, that separates Eastern Jackson County from the rest of the area. So I would think Republican and Democratic legislators, particularly from Eastern Jackson County, from Lafayette County to the east of us and beyond, should have a great interest in making sure this is something that we address long term.
Thank you.
Can you do one more quick one?
Well, since baseball or downtown baseball, everyone comes together on downtown baseball.
Yeah.
That's so central to KC Mo.
Yeah.
How could the footprint or a different footprint or a different location help get you guys to yes or make it easier for the city to do something? You know, maybe not as big, maybe not
sure.
All the streets and all the buildings they talked about before.
You know, I think Kansas City is very interested in getting to yes. We will work with the teams our level best to make sure we lay out a good offer. I mean, the story now is that today was largely, in my opinion, about leverage. And the teams are in an exceptional leverage position. Now I think what they are able to say is, what's the best deal we can get over here? What's the best deal we can get over here? And then at the end of the day, right, what's the one we're going to take? And so I think necessarily you will see every jurisdiction come with a stronger conversation of what does a stadium district look like? What is its walkability? What is its accessibility to public transit, which is something that I think downtown Kansas City is very unique in being able to offer in connection with the Royals. And frankly, even if you look at streetcar and beyond, something that could extend to the east side of Kansas City, the VA Hospital and ultimately Arrowhead Stadium is a Kansas City unique conversation. But I think what we saw in gaining leverage is also something that injects great uncertainty in terms of what the future of our facilities and our teams may be. So for us in downtown Kansas City, I'll be honest with you, I think we look at a map of downtown Kansas City, we see everything that's an option. I think for all of the Kansas City metro, including jurisdictions outside of Kansas City, Missouri, we look at what is the opportunity for the Royals and the Chiefs, how can jurisdictions work together, and how do we put our best foot forward. It shouldn't just be a money conversation, but also a long-term development conversation too. All right.
Some fans,
yep.
some Royals fans like the Royals are right.
Yep, that's very true.
By voting to move the stadium in the first place, did Missouri kind of set themselves up for this controversy?
You know, it's a fair question. I mean, I think that it wasn't just the Jackson County legislators who were interested in elections, so were the teams. and the teams were interested in an election at the time they were. I think all of us were a bit surprised by the outcome, but perhaps we should not have been, particularly coming off of a year of property tax assessments, coming off of any number of concerns with issues in Jackson County recently. The voters, I think, spoke and said very clearly that they had concerns. You know, what I won't do at this point is kind of look all the water under the bridge. I think right now we've got two very important and clear goals. One, how do we make sure the Chiefs and Royals have viable opportunities to stay in Kansas City, Missouri long term? Second, how do we make sure they have viable opportunities to stay in the region? In connection with all of those, we need to talk about a group that hasn't been talked about enough in recent weeks. How is it responsible for our taxpayers? I think the people of Kansas City certainly want us to have great teams. They also want us to have great roads, great schools, great law enforcement. And so we're trying to figure out how to balance that. Importantly, for those of us in Kansas City, Missouri, we have to balance that while we think about perhaps long-term funding asks on the Country Club Plaza, further development on the riverfront, the ongoing development of Kansas City. I'm proud of where Kansas City is right now. I've been mayor for 5 years. Our population is the highest it's ever been. We're attracting great conferences. And we actually attracted the World Cup to Arrowhead Stadium. The most interesting part of this whole conversation. We're investing tens of millions of dollars in a better Arrowhead Stadium. You know, make it make sense. And I think the goal for us is, how do we make this all make sense, that the substantial investments coming from the state of Missouri, which exceed, I think, $50 million. If the governor signs on further appropriations, roughly $85 million to support World Cup, particularly Arrowhead Stadium. The Kansas City taxpayers, $15 million in. How do we make it all make sense that investments we're making now aren't lost 5 years later? All right. Thank you all so much. Have a great day. We'll see you all.